VectorScribe contains a tool called PathScribe. And PathScribe has been one of the core fundamental tools within the Astute Graphics plugin range for Adobe Illustrator for many years. Now, we have produced an Easter egg for PathScribe that was actually released some time ago. And it's only just been discovered, and we wanted to actually now make it a true, proper release. And it's all about Delaunay triangulation. Now, for this demonstration, what I've done, I've downloaded an image from the Adobe stock. This is a photo from Adobe stock, you can see here. And I've also got some panels prepared. I'm going to be using the Find Replace Art tool, PathScribe, which I mentioned previously, so this is just the panel for PathScribe here, the Layers panel, and some swatches. I've also got the Astute Buddy panel open, so I can reference it when I use some other tools. I'm going to start with this bottle, which is a simple image placed on a single layer, you can see here. I'm going to drag that layer to the plus icon to duplicate it, and lock down and hide that original layer. Now I can target this new top layer. And I'm going to select it, and then I'm going to go to the Effect menu, and I'm going to go for Stippleism, and I'm going to go for Stipple. Now this Stipple effect hasn't got any tools associated with it, it is just driven through this one window. And I'm going to, first of all, click on Preview, so I can see what's going to happen to this artwork. And I'm going to reduce the dot size down to 3 pixels to make it much finer, and increase the quality up to 9. Now, if you increase the quality even further to, say, 10 or even 11, then you'll be waiting a bit longer for this to render. Then I'm going to hit the Tab key so that quality of 9 is applied, and we can see it here. This is the result. It's a very, very nice result. So what it is, those dots are representing the grayscale tones of the original image. And I'm going to click on OK. Now, remember, this is applied as a live effect. So to do anything with it, the first thing I'm going to do is to Object, Expand Appearance. Then I'm going to ungroup things. So I use the Shift Command G on the Mac. And I do that twice to make sure everything is ungrouped. And I'm going to get rid of the top dots up there. I don't need the dots around the top of the bottle. And we're left with a series of dots or circles that are actually truly vector. So these are stipple dots. So they're representing the underlying original image as pure vector dots. And if I select one, you can see each one is made up of the standard 4 Bezier curves. Let me zoom out again. Now the triangulation method we're going to be using will join any points that are selected in the artwork. Now I don't actually want it to consider all 4 points in every single one of these dots. I want it to only look at a dot as a single point. So we're going to have to do something first to convert these circles made of 4 Beziers into a single point. To do that, I'm going to be using Find Replace. So I'm going to expand the panel out. And now I'm going to go to the Pen tool and simply click once on the artboard, somewhere else like that, and then hit the Escape key. So this is a single dot on the artboard that has normally very little value. But with that dot selected still, I'm going to go to the Find Replace Art and use the pipette in the Replace section to copy that single dot, because we're going to be using that. So I'm going to go back to the Select tool. I can delete that dot, I don't need the dot on the artboard now. I'm going to select all the artwork here, and you can see all this I want to convert into that single dot. So I have here in the Find Replace panel the default search for any in terms of kind, and replace with that dot. And I'm going to replace it with the bounding box center option here, which again should be default. And I'll click on Replace All. Now you can see those dots selected with the little blue annotation, but if I was to click anywhere else, suddenly all vanishes. That is until I go into the outline rendering mode, and you can see those dots are represented as these tiny crosses on the screen here. So if I were to select them all now, you can see they're all highlighted once more. I'll just tuck the Find Replace panel out of the way a bit. And now finally I'm going to go across to the PathScribe panel, which you can see is docked up in the top right here, and use the flyout menu. And because I have some artwork selected, I have the option now to go for the Delaunay Triangulate menu entry. I'm going to leave everything as default. So by default, it's going to remove sharp triangles. These are little slivers of triangle that basically I don't want. So I'm going to make sure those ones are removed. I'm also going to ignore the retain original paths because these are just single points on the artboard. I don't want them after I've done the conversion. And then I'm going to click on OK. And if I were to click somewhere else, you can now see how it has converted that artwork of simple points into a series of meshed triangles. Now you have no control as to which point is going to mesh with another one. You know, they're all going to mesh to the neighbors really, but in terms of how it triangulates it, you haven't really got a way to control that. It just creates an effect at the end of it. Now I'm still in the outline mode, so if I go back to the fully rendered mode, you can see each one has been filled with black. So you can't really see anything, it's like one big blob at the moment. So I'm going to fill everything with this light blue shade, and you can see I've got a series of blue shades here, or cyan shades. And if I go to View, Hide Edges, it's easy to see that light shade in one go there. And now I'm going to click and hold down on the main selection tool and go for the Astute Graphics Super Marquee tool. Because what I want to do is randomly select from that selection. So first of all, before I do that, I'm going to select everything. And remember, I've hidden edges so you can't see it. And then ungroup everything. So I'm going to do Shift-Command-G twice. And now if I drag the Super Marquee tool over it, you can see that selection growing there when I drag over it. So I'm going to leave the mouse held down, and I'm going to hit the R key for random. And you can see that it's randomly selecting 50% of those triangles. Now, with the mouse key still held down, I'm going to hit the down arrow, because I'm referring to the Astute Buddy panel, and it shows that the down arrow will change the random value. So I'm going to go for about 30%. So only 30% of those triangles are now selected. With them selected, I can click on the second color swatch. And now I'm going to do it again. And you can see why I've hidden the edges, because I want to see what the effect is without the annotation edges coming in the way. Let me do it again. And then one more time for the fifth color swatch. There we go. So it's just a random selection of colors. And you create this lovely sort of shard glass look. Now what I'm going to do is reintroduce the original bottle image underneath. I'm then going to target this Delaunay triangle layer that I've been creating. So you can see it is still selected, but you can't see the edges at the moment. And then I'm going to change the opacity type off that targeted layer with all those triangles in it. And I'm going to go for, well, there are several options I can go for. I could go for hard light, which will create that effect. Soft light creates a much, much more subtle effect to this. Or screen, that's quite a nice one actually. Or I could go for something like exclusion perhaps, which really throws things around. Hue doesn't actually come up with anything. So you see, that's why I'm hiding the edges, so I can see exactly what the end effect is going to be. And there, I've found the one I want. Color burn. Color burn is exactly what I want. Now, you can see there's some triangles popping out of the bottom of the bottle here. So what I could either do is delete them, or with them all selected, I'm just going to move them up, actually. And if I zoom out again, actually, that works even better than deleting them. And there we go. We have our Delaunay triangle effect applied to this bottle. And it's great to just experiment with this new functionality. All Astute Graphics customers, please go to your Astute manager. Make sure you've updated all your plugins, and you too will be able to start experimenting with this new feature.